Uncle Mud here on this fine September morning in Northeast Ohio. It got down around freezing last night, which gives me a great excuse to fire up my Liberator rocket heater and answer some questions. E. Mitchell asked us on YouTube about the connection between the Liberator and the thermal mass bench that stores the heat overnight, so I thought I'd show you our setup here. We've used this Liberator in several different configurations, including firing it up. We did a YouTube video last winter of the pellet heat hopper there, the pellet heater option. It doesn't require electricity and it burns a sack of pellets overnight, lasts 8 to 12 hours. That's really handy. I mostly run mine on scrap wood. I've got a couple pieces of 2x4 in there all right now. And it heats the inside of this bench. This cob bench is hollow, and the exhaust comes in the bottom end of one side. And then the hot gases rise in the hollow space and warm the inside of the cob bench. And the chimney comes out of the bottom of the other end and goes up out of the house. But most of the heat gets stored in this thermal mass bench with pretty sculpty things and whatnot. And lets us be warm in the morning when we wake up. You can find the Liberator at rocketheater.com, and our buddies Sky Huddleston and his family in Missouri, United States, build these things. They're UL listed, so your insurance company and your local code guys will be happy to not argue with you about your rocket mass heater. It just installs like a wood stove. The Mark II version is out with a design including rocket mass heater option, the thermal mass bench plug-in. And they made their own glass window for watching the fire like I did here. This is part of the options on the heater. And if you tell them that Uncle Mud sent you, they'll give you $100 off. Shameless promotion here. And if you want to see the rocket heaters that we build ourselves, you can join us at patreon.com/UncleMud and check out the videos we've been putting up. Have a lovely day. Stay warm.